Assalamu alaikum. How are you, my friends? This is the second video for lecture number 8, which is talking about level measurements. We remember that we said in the last video, level is very important to measure. Now, in this lecture or in this video, we want to know what are the famous used formula in measuring the level. Let us start. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم والصلاة والسلام على الرسول الكريم وبعد. One of the basics, or can say also one of the main formula used in measuring the level is the hydrostatic pressure formula. This formula, it can be used in measuring the level, and we know that pressure is equal the height of level of material inside the tanks, multiply the acceleration of gravity, multiply the density of material. All of them are equaling to the hydrostatic pressure. Of course, when I say hydrostatic, mean the liquid does not move inside the tanks. So I can utilize this equation by finding a differential pressure between two points in the container. Normally, one of them at 0% level and the others at 100%, but it is not necessary in every case. This is the equations. We can just modify both the H here on one side and put the hydrostatic pressure in the other side, divided by the specific weight, or you can say divided by density multiplied acceleration of gravity. Let us take example to solve this one. Example saying that a sensor measured 35,621.5 pascal differential pressure in a tank contains a liquid has SG, that's mean specific gravity, equal to 0.985. What is the level of this liquid? Simply, just let's start. Pressure for non-moved static liquid inside the tanks mean we can utilize the hydrostatic pressure formula. So we can use the formula and substitute these values. Pressure 35,620, and the specific weight can be found by the given specific gravity. We know that the formula for specific weight, if we related it with the specific gravity, we can say that the specific weight of the liquid equal the specific gravity of the liquid multiply the standard material. Normally we said that the standard material specific weight, they are two, either water for solids and liquids and air for gases. Our method here, our example here, is liquid. So we will choose water. Specific gravity multiply specific weight of water. Now, the given specific gravity is 0.985 multiply the specific gravity, the specific weight of water, which is 9,810 newton per meter cube. Just substitute all of them. It will give me the specific weight of the liquid. 9,662.85 newton per meter cube. Note, it is a force over volume. Now, we can manipulate the formula a little bit to find the heights. We can divide the pressure by the specific weight of the liquid. Now, this will give me 3.69 meter. Note that kg went to the kg, meter went with the square here, also second square here went with the second square. The remaining me just only meter in the denominator, and we know that denominator of the denominator is a numerator. Pliancy force. Pliancy force concept is already explained previously in the pressure measurement. Also, we can utilize the idea here in our level measurement. Buoyancy force is used normally in displaced object over a fluid. It should be that this object must have a density greater than the liquid, or otherwise you cannot utilize the buoyancy force. The formula for buoyancy force is B equal specific weight of fluid multiply the volume displaced, which is equal the specific weight of fluid multiply instead of volume, we divide it in two parts. The object base area, which is similar to the area base for the liquid displaced fluid, but the height of the change in the fluid will be calculated this time to consider our volume displaced fluid. Now, in order to find the buoyancy force, take the apparent weight and subtract it from the object weight. So our weight apparent here equal the weight of object, which is normally greater than the buoyancy force. Subtract the buoyancy force element, it will give me the apparent. Then we can say, and otherwise by reordering them, buoyancy equal the weight of object minus the apparent weight. Just we measure the weight that appear to us and we'll subtract it from the weight of object, simply like that. Then a displacer with a diameter of 4 centimeters is used to measure change. This is an example. A displacer with a diameter of 4 centimeters is used to measure changes in water level. If the water level changes by 1.2 meter, what is the change in force sensed by the force sensor? Notes here, it gives me the diameter of the displaced objects, the diameter of its base area, and we can use it even though in the liquid displaced area. So to measure it, we can utilize also buoyancy force. Changing in the height lead to a change in the apparent weight, then formula for apparent weight will be like that. Delta W apparent, which means the first apparent weight minus the second apparent weight. Note that the apparent weight here is decreased. That's why the second is less than the first. Yes. Okay. The formula can be adjusted a little bit. We can say that apparent weight for the first minus the apparent weight for the second equal, now substitute for each one. This bracket for the first one, object minus the first buoyancy, all of them minus the inner brackets for the object minus the second buoyancy. Just manipulate them to see what will be changed here. Substitute, or you can say remove the brackets. Of course the signs are changed. We know now the weight of object will delete each other. The remaining for me is the buoyancy 2 minus buoyancy 1 because of the effect of a sign. These are also expressing the change in the weight apparent. So there is no difference. We can utilize just the difference between the two buoyancies. This is the benefit of this formula. Now, I will substitute for the second buoyancy displaced fluid, which is the specific weight of fluid multiply the volume of the second displaced fluid minus the buoyancy one. Okay, buoyancy one also is the specific weight for the same fluid multiply the first displaced fluid volume, not the second. So the difference is here, what will appear now. If we substitute for the volume, we know that the area of object base, it can be applicable for both of them. So it is the area of the base of the object displaced multiply the height of the second submerged, all of them minus the specific weight multiply this first displaced fluid. Also, we can substitute for the first displaced volume, which give me also the area of object base multiply the height of the first submerged. Now we can just manipulate this formula a little bit. We take this common factor for the specific weight and the object of base, and we can just take the difference between the second and the first height of the submerged level. You can say delta H multiply the specific weight of fluid multiply the object base. So if we divide these two things by under the apparent or the change in the apparent weight, we can find the change in the height. So in this example, we already given the height, just we want to see what will be the change in the apparent weight. Just substitute a specific fluid we already calculated, we already know it, which is the water here as is given in our example, and the object base diameter 4 centimeter, just we substitute it in meter sense in order to make all the units are equals. Meter square multiply the height, which is 1.2 meters, meter with meter square, all of these deleting the meter cube here, the remaining part for me is Newton. Now we will go to the other concept for measuring the level. Also, it utilizes the weight, but in this case in other sense. Normally it is used with the strain gauges, or can say load cells, under certain container vessel, which will be changed based on the change in the vessel weight. It can be found by taking the difference between the vessel weight with the fluid and its weight without the fluid. This is the formula: the weight of fluid equal the total weight minus the weight of empty container. Now we can utilize this formula also to substitute for the fluid weight. We know this formula: a specific weight of the fluid multiply the volume of the fluid, which is give me the weight of the fluid. Nice. Now the height can be found by the fluid weight. Simply just substitute for the volume, which is equal the base of the container multiply the height of the fluid. This is the volume of the fluid. This is the volume of what? The volume of the fluid. And we know that the fluid normally it take the shape of their containers. So we can calculate the base area, the area of the base of this container, as area for the fluid volumes. Now we just by manipulation a little bit, we can put H in one side and we say it is the weight of the fluid divided by the specific weight of the fluid, which is multiplied by the container based area. Let us take this example. What is the depth of a liquid in a container if the specific weight of the liquid is 82 bound force over feet cube? The container weight is 45 bound and is 21 inch, the type of it, in diameter. So its diameter is 21 inch. A weight sensor measures a total weight of around 385 pounds. Not here, Shabab. LB. Also, it is available in other parts. LB, LB. All of them are expression or are the unit for bound force, not bound mass. Be careful for this one a little bit, because we are talking here about specific weight and the weight of the load cell. This is the distinguish, or that is the method of segregating. Is it force or mass? Now let us answer this question. The weight of the container with liquid is 385. This is the total weights, which is measured by the weight sensors. Also, the weight sensor give us already previously the empty container weight, which is equal 45 pound force. So we have the total and the empty. Subtract both of them, it will give me the weight of the liquid. Now I found the weight of liquid, I can utilize it, which is give me this result, 340 pound force. We can just substitute for the weight by replacing it by specific weight and the volume. Now we can substitute for the volume of the fluid, which is already agreed with that. It is the container base area base of the container times the height of the liquid. Substitute all of them, and with some manipulation we can say this weight of liquid, which is already founded, 340 pound force over the specific weight of liquid and the area of container. Area of the container base, just we need to find it. It mentioned in the example that the base has a diameter. When he said it is a diameter, that means it is a cylindrical shape, because he said diameter, and the diameter will comes normally with the circles, does not come with the square or triangle or other shape, it comes with the circle. So that means the base is a circle, and we know that the area of the circle is by multiply the radius square, but he gave us the diameters, not the radius. So it is the diameter square over 4. We know that radius, it is diameter over 2. If we square both of them, that will becomes diameter square over 4. Substitute the diameters, which is 21 inch square, all of them divided by 4, multiply by, notes here, I divide this 21 by 12 inch. In order to what? I will change the diameter, the dimension, from inch to feet, in order to make the units are equal. So the container base will be by multiply 3.062 over 4, which is give me this result, 2.40.053 feet square. Now I can go to my formula. The height of the liquid, which is equal the weight of the liquid, 340 pounds over the specific weight of the liquid, multiplied by the container base. We found the container base, 2.4053, and we know the liquid specific weight, which is given in the example as 82 pound force over feet cube. خلاص, just substitute it and you will find the results, which is give me 1.724 feet. Maybe with some approximation happens in previous steps, maybe it will affect little bit on the value. Instead of saying 1.724, maybe you will find it as 1.726 or 0.731. Depend on your approximation method. So it's not matter. The majority number here is 1.724 is enough. Now, the other concepts for measuring the level, it is the capacitance change concept. Here, the level can be measured by changing the capacitance of a probe. Normally, this probe design can be a long rod shape with the strips, and we can consider them as plates inside this probe. Also, is not necessary in every case. It can be inside the probe's tube, or it can be strips, or as a rod, electrical rod, considered as electric cathode related with the wall of the container, if the container is metal. If the wall of the container is metal. But no, most of the time you can see strips inside these probes in order to find the capacitance between them. These strips of probes has a dielectric in case if there is no fluid. After filling the probes by the liquid, which is comes upper and upper, and when it is increased, it will comes also through this probe rod and will start filling the space between these strips or between the cathode, electric cathode to the wall, whatever, depend your design, and we will see in the type of the devices. Now the dielectric will be changed between the probe strips. The used formula for these probes is this one: CD equals CA multiply mu multiply D over R. All of them are added with the difference between 1 and the division of D over R multiply CE. Now let's talk about this formula a little bit. Note, this is our formula. Mu is indicating for the dielectric of the liquid inside the tanks, and it is given constant depend on the liquid types. Capacitance at empty tank, that means what will be the capacitance if the tank is empty. R is indicating for the height of the blade strips. Now, because of these strips, it must covering all the possible heights for the level. So the length of these strips or the blades of the probes, capacitance problem, it be considered as the 100% level height. Now, D is the depth of the level liquid inside the tanks. It depends how much the depth of the liquid comes inside the tanks, and of course, the probe will be immersed partially or totally inside this liquid. Now, this is the formula. Not here, shabab. If you compare this formula, which is give me the capacitance of the liquid inside the tanks, this is the indication for the CD. If you compare this formula that given here in this slide, you will note there 1 minus D over R. But in your textbook, this D over R, which is subtracted from 1, is not written in your textbook. So you need to go your textbook and correct the formula there, which is I think in page 86, I think that's say 86 or 68, check it, chapter 6, by the way. To go to the chapter 6, go to the formula for the capacitance of the level measurements inside your textbook, and you need to adjust it. Instead of CA only, write this bracket and write 1 minus D over R. This is the correct formula. Now we will take example for the capacitance measurements for level. A capacitive probe 25 centimeters long, the type of this capacitor is 25 centimeter types, has a capacitance of 22 picofarads, that means 22 multiplied 10 to the power minus 12 in air, when partially immersed in water with dielectric constant of 80, the capacitance becomes 1.1 nanofarad, or 1.1 multiplied 10 to the power minus 9. What is the length of the probe immersed in the water? When he mentioned capacitance, we can utilize our formula. Let us just order the given values. Length of the probe, R. He mentioned it is 25 centimeters types, so its probe length is 25 centimeters. This is the maximum level it can be measured by this type or by this defined level probes. Its capacitance in case if there is no liquid, or you can say in the air, is CA equal 22 picofarads. The dielectric of the liquid is mu equal 80. Its capacitance with existence of the liquid is CD equal 1.1 nanofarad. Let's go to our formula and we'll try to substitute. CD 1.1 nanofarad, CA 22 picofarad, mu 80, and D over R. Of course, D still not known for us, but we know R is 25 centimeters. And 1 minus also D over 25 centimeters. Then multiply these by the capacitance in the air, CA. Now, we will start to rearrange some parts. We take as a common factor for CA and DR, and we take them out of the mu minus 1 as a common factor. Also, if we substitute of them, it becomes 1.1 nanofarad for CD, 22 picofarad for CA, and mu minus 1, which becomes 80 minus 1, the result will be 79. D over R, or you can say D over 25 centimeters, all of them are plus or added with 22 picofarad, which is the capacitance in the air, or the capacitance without a fluid inside the tanks or the vessel. Just some manipulations of them. We will take D, which is our desired value here, which is comes now as the CD, the capacitance with the fluid inside the proper, minus the capacitance without the fluid inside the proper, all of them divided by the capacitance of the probes without fluid. Even also multiply the difference between the mu and 1, and our mu is 8 in this case, which is give me a result 79. All of them are multiplied by the total level of the probe, which is R here. This will give me D. Just substitute the values. 1.1 nanofarad minus 22 picofarad. All of them over 22 picofarad multiplied by 80 minus 1. Or you can say multiply 79. All of them multiplied by 25 centimeter to give me the height of the liquid inside the probe. Or the height of the liquid for the immersed probe. Now, just in order to delete this farad from each other, instead of nano, I will convert it to pico. So I can delete this picofarad with this picofarad with the denominator ones. So they are deleted. The remaining for me is centimeters. Substitute the values. It will give me, after the calculations, 15.506 centimeter for the immersed part of the probe inside the liquid. Note that the unit system types of the level does not affect in this equation. So, if I give you R instead of centimeter, I give it to you in feet. Doesn't matter. All these values are the same. Does not affect. It will give me in the end as a ratio. If not here, it is a ratio. Ratio multiply the height, whatever the height. Feet, inch, centimeter, meter. So you don't need to make conversion, unit conversion here in this case, because it's already a ratio calculation. There is another concept which is talking about the time reflections, the calculating the time reflections of certain waves or certain media, and we can measure through by them measuring the level. But I will not explain it here. Maybe I will explain it by coming video, which is talking about the types of the level measurement. I prepare this video for you and these slides for you, and I think it is better than this slides, which is old one, old slides, which is already uploaded in your blackboard. And yes, this is the page 87, page, yes, page 87. Correct this formula in your page 87. This is only one page here, but I explain it in this new slide that I already shown and explained previously. Thank you, gentlemen, for listening for this video and watching it. then waiting for me for the coming Zui video, and we will see you inshallah later. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah.